Please do click on the bell icon so that you never miss any update. Monsoon, probably the worst season for riders, and that's because it creates tough condition. Riding becomes risky and maintenance becomes difficult. But small things can really reduce your efforts. So what are they? Let's see it. I'm really sorry to upload this video very late, but they say that it's never too late. Now you might be wondering what I have really done. Well, there is nothing much I have done. If you really trust me, this is sufficient enough to protect your bike from rain. Believe me, these three covers are more than sufficient. Tank cover which protects the water from entering your petrol tank, and these two switch covers that prevents water from entering the circuits. In addition, a speedometer cover is always a bonus. But why not a full cover? A single cover protects the whole handlebar. Let me tell you why. Yes, it protects, but it also damaged my paint, which later I restored by Teflon coating. The plastic was literally scrubbing off my paint. The water from the cover used to drip on the mudguard, so the continuous dripping process created a whitish spot and it was difficult to remove. Even that was restored in the Teflon process. I never had this kind of cover, but let me tell you that this sticks to your paint. And here you have another damage. So that's why these covers are more useful. There are hardly any chances of water reaching your tank unless there is any kind of leakage on your cover. One more thing, when you close the zip, make sure that the zip is inside the cover. Why? Cause even this causes damage. Don't know if you are able to see this, but there are minor ones and which are negligible. There is no specific speedometer cover for Gixxer, so I bought one of Yamaha, which is slightly bigger. The cover is quite decent and details are easily visible through it. However, the digital speedometer is pretty much water resistant, still you can use it for additional safety measures. Switch covers help in keeping water away from the electrical circuits. Switches are more likely to get rusted and hence it is necessary to keep it covered. This damage is caused by my seat cover. Wondering how? That's because of the loose elastic cover. Water used to slide down from the small grooves and which used to drip continuously in that area. Hence it is recommended to either use a good cover or get it laminated. However, the stock seat cover is also good and there is nothing to worry about it. In the engine area, little bit of coating was scraped off and that's why I have given it a single layer coat of heat resistant spray on it. If you have an aluminium engine, then you don't need to worry about rusting, but beware about corrosion. Your chrome parts are very likely to get rusty. Luckily for Gixxer, it's only the silencer which gets a small coat. For those having Royal Enfield, must specially look out for. Bike manufacturers use good quality of material, but if you find any spot of rust, you can anytime coat it with anti-rust and later remove it with kerosene. Keep an eye on this kind of small nuts because they are much likely to get rusted easily. If you have a leaking oil seal, then get it replaced as soon as possible, especially in rainy season. Because if water goes inside it, it will also drag dust and dirt inside and it will cause internal rusting of rod. And if the rod gets damaged, then it will cut your oil seal later on, leaving you only one option to replace the complete rod. Chains are very hard to maintain in rainy season. Even after lubing it, it will still become very rusty quickly. So what I have done is I have applied grease on the side walls and sprayed lube on the inner side. And after a month of observation, I found that the rusting has been reduced to 85%. Keeping your bike clean is also one of the major tasks that most of us avoid doing. Mud absorbs moisture and it leads to rusting. So no matter how much precaution you take, rusting will still occur if you don't wash it. And last step is always keeping it covered whenever possible to keep away from rain. So that's it for today. Hope these tips are useful for you. And if you have a better solution, do comment in the comment section below. I'll be happy to hear it from you. So ride safe and take care of your bike.